My name is Dee Harley and I run Harley Farms Goat Dairy in Pescadero. On the 9 acres where we currently have our dairy farm, 6 acres is in pasture. The rest is the actual dairy barn and milking parlour and some garden. We make cheese from the milk that we produce from our own animals. We have 200 goats. We also have an edible garden. We use a lot of edible flowers on the cheese products that we make, and we also have a farm garden because we do farm dinners on a monthly basis. We grow most, if not all, of the food right here on the farm. And we'll produce 200 pounds of cheese on a daily basis. But ultimately, the goats have got to be taken care of first, and the people, of course, and maintain the sustainability of the farm. We can't compromise that. Water obviously has become a huge, important resource to run a dairy operation. It takes quite a lot of water. We call it liquid gold. We put this recycling system on the pasteurizer, which takes water out to a cooling system, which cools the milk. And we collect water from the loafing barn roofing area, which is a metal roof. We have 2 rainwater collection tanks that each hold just under 5,000 gallons. And it's just kind of all the use of water, but it's just sending it in different directions. The way the water catchment system that we have works is this metal roof, the rain falls down, and then comes down this large gutter system, and then that tank is then attached to 13 water troughs that the goats drink from.
We're on the wash-up cycle now after milking the goats. We catch all of the water in 5 gallon buckets as it comes back, and then we use that water to swill down the holding pen to clean up the floor in here, and then gets recycled out onto the pasture. All the water that we use to clean up the dairy floor and the equipment and the pasteurizer and general things also goes down the drain here and joins all that water that we get from the milking parlor, and then it gets recycled out onto the pasture.
There's an annual maintenance of the system, if you will. We do clean off the metal roof. We clean out the drain pipe. Other than that, there's very little filtration or maintenance, really. Having a dairy farm in this area has been a good and a bad thing. We're the only dairy in San Mateo County. But it also has been really good because it's forced us to do things as efficiently as possible. We applied for and were awarded an EQIP grant. The grant that I originally got was for $247,000. It was a cost share grant, so over the course of 8 years, I've come up with half of that. The well that we dug for the irrigation, so then we wouldn't have to take from the creek, was a $40,000 project. The rainwater catchment system that we have was a $20,000 project. The recycling system on the pasteurizer was a $10,000 project and was not part of the grant. I did that by myself. And then the irrigation part and the fencing all had added up to the rest of the grant. One of the last parts of the EQIP grant that we were awarded was to dig an irrigation well, so then we could leave the water in the creek. Our goal is to eliminate drawing any water from the creek at all. So it's been an important partnership, and one that continues, because there's always new and interesting grants and available funding for people. When I say that it's easy for anybody to do something like this, there is the practical part of you do need, or I needed a tractor to dig the hole, so then we could make the area where we put our rainwater collection tanks in, and then labour, plumbers. We did need, you know, drills and people who knew about pumps, how to install them, and other basic kind of electrical and plumbing help. One of the huge benefits for me personally for having the rainwater collection system that we have is that I'm allowed to have a garden now. So now we're able to grow all our own edible flowers and herbs and vegetables for the farm dinners. We probably save hours per day with the recycling water systems, collecting over 40,000 gallons of rain per year. But I love watching the rain fall and pounce off the roof, knowing that it's being stored. That's what it's all about. And it's clean, it's fresh, it's well looked after, well maintained, it fell from the sky. I was always going to be a farmer. My jobs have always been on farms, really. And I didn't know it would manifest into goats. But I think when I look back at the farm and how it's grown and evolved, I've also grown with it. One of the joys has been resurrecting this old farm to something that's full of life again. And we're farming. We're not driving away from our home and going to our farm. We live and breathe our farm. And we have various different sources of water. We have the creek, we have the water catchment system, the rainwater catchment system. We have our own well and we have an irrigation well. And really, it's a necessity. I mean, I really don't say liquid gold lightly. It really is, and I think we're ahead of the game in the fact that we're thinking to the future.